this is, here in this picture we see the home, the cottage in which Mahatma Gandhi lived. And this cottage is where Mrs. Hillary Clinton came. And the reason why I'm showing is this, because Reverend Martin Luther came to this cottage and felt so at home with everything that he burst out in tears. Now, here is this picture you see on the walls is a picture that was given as a gift to Reverend Martin Luther King by my father, who is the son of Mahatma Gandhi, called Ramdas Gandhi. And Reverend was so grateful to my father, Ramdas, that he has written a letter. Now, this is the letter Reverend Martin wrote to my father, as you can see the date. Now, let me tell you the contents. Contents is that I'm so grateful. I'm sad that I couldn't meet your illustrious father, but Mr. Ramdas, you have made up for it by your wonderful, the way you treated. And more and more I feel, here is Martin Luther King from America telling my father that I feel the security of colored people all over the world lies in adopting active non-violence. The difference between other people and Mahatma Gandhi was this, that his non-violent principle was an active. Mahatma Gandhi was an aggressive person.
And this picture now.
Okay, so I'm more, here is Bapu's good luck puppy. Whenever Bapu had to do something, he could have taken his
wife.
What
is he doing? What's the flag about?
Here Bapu is addressing a crowd of volunteers who had given up their jobs and they were trying to serve Mahatma Gandhi. So they had a flag for their organization. And so India is a big country.
And this is 36, 37?
I think this is 35. This is 1935. So I think I was about 4.5 years old at the time. But it was customary with my grandfather to always pull me and keep me along with him as a good luck charm or my education. Because actually it was Mahatma Gandhi who taught me about the slavery in America and how he was going to remedy the situation without resort to violence. In the spirit of love, taught to us by Lord Christ originally, my grandfather... Mahatma Gandhi, my father was always given to writing
these letters. To you? That's your
name? This is right. In Hindi, you see, Bapu has written Kanu Gandhi. But here he has written Chiranjeevi Kanam. Bapu used to call me Chiranjeevi Kanam. So then. Now, this is the symbolic thing, spinning wheel, which Mahatma Gandhi used to
make clothes.
So
the British can exploit the...
Right, so that we don't buy anything from Britain. Britain had a very captive market in India, where they forced us to buy their cloth manufactured in England. So that it was the British labor which was able to exploit India. So Bapu invented. Well, here Mahatma Gandhi had a very special way of educating his young child. He didn't like me to go to English schools or study English. No, he wanted me.
This is you again standing next to you.
Right, I am again. And here I brought a calf originally, so that the calf you can see in the picture on Mahatma Gandhi's left. And I'm on the right. And Bapu told me at the time that look, you brought the calf, but take me around and show what you're doing with the with other cows. So I'm giving him in presence of Mahatma Gandhi. I have to behave like a senior, responsible person trying to do things for him. So here I'm pretending to be responsible. Okay. My grandfather's greatest admirer was Einstein, and we all know what Einstein said about... Einstein didn't have much respect for fellow scientists because he was head and shoulder above everyone in intelligence. But when he came in contact with Mahatma Gandhi, he had to say that I'm so shocked that there's no one capable of even reaching the heights of Mahatma Gandhi. And generations later, people will scarce believe that such a man as Gandhi was ever walked in flesh and blood. Now, this is the highest tribute from a man who is revered, whose name is revered now at Harvard University, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and NASA.